As God's people, Hope Lutheran Church started as a spark in 1925, when a group of people knocked on the doors of their South Minneapolis neighbors, and after learning who their neighbors were, determined a Sunday school was needed in the area south of Lake Nokomis. I'll let Hope's former music director and historian take the story from here, as Warren Elness writes this letter to be shared today. A greeting to my good friends and former co-workers of Hope Lutheran Church in South Minneapolis at the congregation's last service, December 27th, 2020. I'm grateful to Pastor Eric for asking me for some reflections to share with you in your last Sunday worship service as a congregation, with a tenure lasting from September of 1964 to September of 2003, I have an oversupply of reflections, so I'm giving my permission to omit the last 40 to 50 pages. I think it's safe to say that I was not an ordinary church musician, and that Hope was not an ordinary church building or congregation. If my music program at Hope was successful, it was largely due to the congregation's remarkable willingness to let me custom build a program to fit its unique makeup, its strengths, and its personality. Parish pastors are often given this kind of latitude when they are called, but staff members rarely are. I felt support and cooperation around every corner, month after month, year after year. All the expectations were the ones I set for myself. I had a free hand as long as I didn't burn the place down. I had come to Hope at the request of Pastor John Jorgensen, who I had come to know when he was a seminary intern at the church where I had previously worked. He was very interested in a program for children I had been developing, in which an active junior choir was supplemented with an appreciation for the Lutheran Church's rich history of worship and its arts. This was something he thought should be part of confirmation. Neither of us thought that his ordination would lead to a call to this church or the opportunity for us to work together. One thing we agreed on from day one, there was hardly any ministry in the parish that was more important or worthy of our best efforts than what was done for the children. If the children felt this was the place for them, their friends and the adults would follow. And they did. Hope Lutheran Church had a unique history. Created in 1928, it was immediately plunged into the Great Depression. Offering plates held nickels and dimes. Pastors served for little or nothing. Then, when things finally began looking up, they were told that their little church was sitting right where the eastbound lanes of the crosstown highway would soon be built. With help from the Synod's Home Mission Board, their exodus led them to a promised land on Cedar Avenue. The first unit was built and the congregation started growing, but the roller coaster ride wasn't done. A pedestrian walk bridge would soon be built exactly where the main worship unit had been planned. If this was how the Holy Spirit had planned it, Hope would learn the meaning of the other virtue, faith. Fortunately, when most southbound traffic on Cedar turned onto Highway 77, a city's service gas station on 58th Street was eager to sell its property. Hope arranged to buy, and the 5-8 had a new neighbor. The new Ralph Rapson Contemporary Church building was dedicated in 1969, and the congregation under Hugh Gilmore and Jim Spertoli saw a dramatic growth spurt. A quite remarkable growth considering it was just a small urban church, with a huge chunk of its surrounding neighborhood being an airport. But there is something about this growth that has been largely forgotten, and I think it's worth remembering on this occasion. Many of the new members were coming from other neighboring parishes, members who, for one reason or another, felt they needed to find a new church home. They weren't looking for a place that would just be the same. They were looking for a church they could call home. And Hope did a wonderful job of welcoming or adopting them into its family. Coffee hour extended well into the week. But here's the kicker. These immigrants from other church homes brought a richness of talents and ideas and volunteer service and Christ-like love and fellowship into their adopted church home. And now you have become the adopted ones and will have the chance to add your gifts to a new and welcoming community of believers. The people of Hope, once the welcoming, now become the welcomed. And it's hard to think of a legacy better than that. I am thankful for what Hope gave to me, and I am proud of what the people of Hope can and will now give to others. May God bless you, and also make of you a blessing to others. Uncle Warren.
Through the years, the members of Hope were shaped by their pastors, and their pastors were impacted by their time at Hope as well.
Pastor Hugh Gilmore writes, "Dear members of Hope, in 1928, a group of dedicated Christians gathered to worship and begin the ministry of Hope Lutheran Church. Today, you are a group of dedicated Christians gathered to worship for a final time as Hope Lutheran Church. Hope's building may be gone, but the impact of Hope's ministry will continue on. From the very beginning, the mission of Hope has been the sharing of the gospel of Jesus Christ and to care for God's people. What a wonderful time Kay, my children, and I had at Hope. The warmth and acceptance we felt was greatly appreciated. I had the privilege of serving as your pastor from 1967 to 1973. The work of God's Spirit in the lives of Hope's members was unlimited. What a joy it was to see creative ministries taking place. The building of a new sanctuary to provide worship space to welcome people from the area. The developing of youth choir trips under the leadership of Warren Elness. The creation of confirmation retreats to nurture the spiritual lives of young people. The formation of the Young at Heart group for Christian fellowship. The dedication of the members reached far beyond those highlighted. The cross is a symbol of hope. I wear a cross on my neck each day, reminding me of the cross of Jesus Christ. It also is a reminder of my time with the wonderful members of Hope Lutheran Church. I remember the day the big cross was erected in Hope's new sanctuary. It was a major project, but reflected the purpose of the congregation. The hymn proclaims, "Lift high the cross, the love of Christ proclaim." A difficult and painful decision was made to close the doors of Hope. I know you will continue to faithfully worship the Lord and serve his people. Love, Pastor Hugh Gilmore. Pastor Jim Spertoli writes, "Thank you for the opportunity to send a few words of thanksgiving to the gathered members of Hope Lutheran Church on Zoom during these days of COVID-19. First and foremost, I want to thank all of you for the privilege that was mine to serve as your pastor. You gave me many gifts during that time. First, there was the gift of a fine staff to work with, the office ministry, the music ministry, the parish ministry, and the folks who kept our buildings clean and neat were wonderful to work with. On top of that, there were the good members of the congregation, people who knew each other not only from being members of Hope, but also because they were neighbors. That gave a special quality to the congregation. Not only did they worship together a loving God, they then put their faith into action, serving others from projects in South Minneapolis to a children's orphanage in Guatemala. Alongside of that was their ability to socialize together. A bus ride to Wisconsin comes to mind. It filled every year. In the midst of that, you surrounded a new pastor and his family and made us feel welcome. You will never know how important that was to our family. Many of my memories come from the time spent with youth of the congregation. I had the opportunity to take regular summer trips with the high school youth to various parts of the country, backpacking across Isle Royale on Lake Superior to a mystery trip ending in the Ozarks. And if that was not enough, getting a chance to camp with Uncle Warren on his junior choir trips topped it off. There are many other occurrences that come to mind. The Parkway Theater, the new organ, the elevator, and I could go on, but I will not. Please know that as you each make a new beginning, remember the words of Isaiah. The grass withers, the flower fades, but the word of God stands forever. Jesus took care of us while we were gathered on Cedar Avenue. He will be close by your side as you continue your walk. God bless. Pastor Jim, Glenna, Jenny, Andrea, and Ed.
Hello, members of Hope Lutheran Church. Pastor Chris Stubing here. Greetings and Merry Christmas. I remember fondly my time serving as pastor at Hope between 2012 and 2015. The ministry experiences we shared together, and most of all, the relationships with members of Hope who have blessed me and my family greatly. Knowing that you gather today as your last Sunday, I'm filled with both sadness and gratitude. Yes, I share in a sense of loss at what has been, and yet I'm grateful for the great things God has done through the ministry of Hope Lutheran Church. I believe that the greatest impact of Christian ministry is often unseen, hidden, held in the hearts and lives and faith of those who have been blessed and nourished by the gospel. As you take this step of faith today, my hope is that you would trust in the promises of God. Trust in God's presence with you now and always, and trust that the work God has been doing all along through Hope has been fruitful. You know, perhaps in ways that you may never know, but in ways that are known by God and by those who trust in Jesus today and who are passing on faith to others because of your faithfulness in ministry. So I want to thank you. Thank you for blessing me with the privilege to serve with you. And may God bless you. And may the Spirit strengthen and guide you for this next part of the journey of following Jesus. God be with you until we meet again. And Merry Christmas.
Many of Hope's members will transfer to Lake Nokomis Lutheran Church, where they will be welcomed and offer their gifts in an ELCA congregation, entering into a bold understanding of what it means to be God's church in South Minneapolis.
Greetings, prayers, blessings to you, friends at Hope Lutheran Church, during this time of transition. I am Pastor Sarah Spohr. I am here at Lake Nokomis Lutheran Church, and on behalf of our congregation, I want to offer a warm welcome to those of you who will be joining us in these days, months, and years ahead. We are excited for all that is to come. One of the most exciting things happening in our midst is a three-church initiative, which some of your members have been a part of the conversations around the dream and the hope and the vision about what God is going to do in this neighborhood. So again, blessings to each one of you in your community as you enter these days of transition, and welcome to those of you who will be joining with us. We are so grateful for the ongoing conversation and ministry together in Christ.
The story of Hope Lutheran Church will accompany a legacy gift to Lake Wapagasset Lutheran Bible Camp, where those who enter the camp facility will be warmly welcomed to retreat from their daily life, explore their faith, and be empowered to live their faith in the world.
Hello, you good people of Hope. What a momentous occasion. We give thanks for all of the ways that you have partnered with and supported our ministries at Ox Lake, Wilderness Canoe Base, and Camp Wapo. We are humbled and inspired by your recent legacy gifts to this ministry. Just incredible. In a very challenging year, you have given us hope. The resources you've shared will allow us to continue to welcome people graciously into the midst of our sites for generations to come. The new Dining Hall and Hospitality Center at WAPO will be a warm space that encourages conversation and community and fellowship. Thank you for helping us share the good news of Jesus.
For over 90 years, the people of Hope Lutheran Church have adapted to a changing neighborhood and a changing world. Through it all, hope in the God who breaks into the world as a child at Christmas, dies on a cross, rises at Easter, conquering sin forever, is at the heart of every gathering and every relationship that marks Hope Lutheran Church. As your pastor for this final leg of Hope's journey, it has been my honor to build Christ-centered relationships with you, to learn from you, to be inspired by your faithfulness and boldness in making hard decisions. In this insert adjective here time of 2020, your decisions have lived out Christ's command to love your neighbor, and that is no small task. It will be hard for me to think about the word hope and not think of each of you and some of the times that we've shared together. In remembrance and with thanksgiving, we now hand over the documented history and official records that symbolize the joys and the sorrows of the people of God in this congregation. While words like close and dissolve may describe the legal language for what is happening, the members of Hope Lutheran Church trust that the story of this congregation continues. And just like for the last 90 plus years, Christ will be made known through the Spirit of Hope.